disorders of the eye and the adnexa. And adnexa just means an appendage or an extension of an organ. The reason this is really an interesting section is because it's not divided up separately with its old chapter in ICD-9, but in ICD-10 it's got its own chapter, and it's chapter 7. So let's see what we've got in there. What's really fun is that that it's moved up. You know, it was a lot of information that had to be integrated, and there was so much of it that now it's got its own chapter. So real quickly, it goes from H00 to H59, and these are what you can code out of the disorders of the eye and the adnexa. Excuse me, you have disorders of the eyelid and the lacrimal system and the orbit. Okay, you have and the lacrimal system. I'm going to show you a picture of the eye here in just a second. Disorders of the conjunctiva, which is you know how women put sometimes they put their eyeliner on the inside ridge of the eye, not just in the where the eyelashes come out. That's the conjunctiva or conjunctiva. H15 through H22, you've got disorders of the sclera, cornea, iris, and ciliary body, and that's kind of all you know, portions of the eye. Then H25 through H28, disorders of the lens. So the lens is a part of the eye, and this whole section will be just disorders of the lens, which there can be all kinds of them. H30 through H36, disorders of the carotid or retina. And I had to, we talked about this when we did our ICD-10 class the other day. I had to go through and look how to say these, because I have problems pronouncing CH words when they're not pronounced CH, and it's not choroid, they're choroid. It's actually a K sound, so it's choroid. Glaucoma, H40 through H42, got a huge section on glaucoma, and we had talked about that in a previous webinar as well, that the different things you need to know when you're going to do glaucoma coding. H43 through H44, disorders of the vitreous body and globe. And that vitreous body is that liquidy part in the eye. H46 through H47, disorders of the optic nerve and visual pathways. And the optic nerve goes in through the back of the eye. Let's see, visual pathway, you know, you come through the iris and it bounces off the back. H49 through H52, disorders of ocular muscles, but not binocular movement, accommodation, and refraction. That's a mouthful. H53 through H54, visual disturbances and blindness. We have H55 through H57, other disorders of the eye and the adnexa. And the adnexa means, you know, just extensions off an organ. And then we have H59, intraoperative and postprocedural complications and disorders of the eye and the adnexa not elsewhere classified. So the things to know about the new Chapter 7, and that, you know, if you're going to be doing a lot of coding here, is the structure of the eye. It's very important that you have a pretty basic understanding of the structure of the eye. So if you cut the eye in half and you look at it, in the front here, this outside layer of the eye, you have the cornea, and the sclera is the white part that you see, okay? Then the ciliary body is actually this little muscle that holds the lens in place and kind of helps the iris, okay? The iris here is the color portion of your eye. So a person who has brown eyes or blue eyes, that's all determined by the iris, okay? And the iris is what opens and closes the hole, the pupil, Okay, so really when you see the black hole there, it's looking into the eye and it's actually just a big hole. And then this iris is what shrinks, you know, and makes a, when you're in the dark, it gets real big and lets in more light. And when someone shines a light in your eye, it gets like a pinpoint. And it literally is the window to the brain, so you can tell if somebody's got a something wrong with their brain, if maybe the pupils aren't equal, or if a person has dilated eyes. Anyway, it's really interesting. Then you have the lens. The aqueous, this is the aqueous humor, and it's the fluid that's there around the lens. We did the sclera, and then we have the vitreous body, or you have vitreous humor, which is like the jelly type stuff inside the eye. You have the retina on the back, and when you have problems with the eye, the retina they can look in the eye and look at the retina and tell what a problem is. You got the choroid, I have trouble saying that still, which is right behind the retina. You have the optic nerve, and all this stuff is so tiny that the light, little bit of swelling or anything can mess up the optic nerve and damage it, and then you've got the optic disc where light comes in and hits that disc. So if you know the basic parts of the eye, then you won't have any problems with Chapter 7. And it's kind of, you know, most of that stuff you usually already know because you might have learned it in school, or, you know, the eye is something in science. They always made you draw the eye. At least they always made us do it. I think they thought it was much easier to draw.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.